This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about terminating and repeating decimals. So you may have noticed that sometimes when you've got a fraction, like let's take the fraction 3 over 11, and you turn that into a decimal, you get what's called a repeating decimal. When we turn 3 over 11 into a decimal, we get 0.272727, and this repeating pattern, 27, is going to keep on going. So I'm just going to write an ellipsis, the three dots, to show that it keeps going. Sometimes you'll see this written as 0.27 and a bar over the digits that repeat, so a bar over the 27, to show that this goes on infinitely. Now, other times you might divide a fraction. You might have something, or you might have a fraction like 7 over 8. And when you turn that into a decimal, you end up with what's called a terminating decimal. So 7 over 8 is going to turn into 0.875. Now, there's a general rule of thumb that tells you how to know whether you're going to end up with a repeating decimal or a terminating decimal. The rule of thumb goes like this. Take your fraction, reduce it to lowest terms. Once it's reduced to lowest terms, factor the denominator. If the denominator has no factors, no prime factors, other than 2 and 5, then you're going to have a terminating decimal. In other words, if all you have is 2s or 5s, or 2 and 5, then you get a terminating decimal. Otherwise, you'll get a repeating decimal. So let's look at some fractions and see if we can figure out whether they'll terminate or repeat. So if I have the fraction 3 over 16, it's reduced as much as possible. I want to factor the denominator, and 16 is 2 to the 4th power. So my only prime factors are going to be 2s, which means this will be a terminating decimal. If I have 11 over 40, it's also reduced as much as possible. If I factor the denominator, 40 is 8 times 5, and 8 is 2 to the 3rd power. That'll be times 5. Now I've got 2s and 5s in the denominator. That's fine. That will give me a terminating decimal, and there's no other prime factors. So this will terminate. If I have 21 over 28, before I decide whether it terminates or not, I've got to reduce it to lowest terms. So 21 and 28 both divide by 7. That means I'm going to end up with 3 over 4. And 4, of course, is 2 times 2, or 2 squared. So this will terminate because all I've got in the denominator is 2s. If I have 5 over 7, this is already reduced. 7 is a prime number. I can't factor it anymore. Since it's a 7 and I haven't got 2s or 5s, I've got a number other than 2 or 5, this will end up being a repeating decimal. If I have 7 over 12, it's reduced. I'm going to have to factor the denominator. 12 is 3 times 4, and 4 is 2 squared. Well, I've got a 2 in the denominator. I've got 2 squared, but I've also got a 3. Which means this is going to be a repeating decimal. Okay? So once again, the basic rule says if you've got a number, a factor, prime factor in the denominator, other than 2 or 5, like a 3 or a 7 or an 11, the first one we started with, you're going to get a repeating decimal. If you don't have anything other than 2 and 5, like here, then you're going to get a terminating decimal. And that's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.